So today, we'll use carousel and map function to work on testimonials. First, let's create a new component. So open your code editor, open components, and here, create a new file, testimonials.js. We'll create a functional component, so add export default function and a component name, app testimonials. In return, let's just add a div tag with the text testimonials. Now let's import this component under app.js. So on top, import app testimonials. Then at the bottom, use app testimonial element. Check the preview and we can see testimonials. It means our component is working. Now let's add this title and a subtitle. Also, let's add the grid layout. So open React Bootstrap, click components, layout and grid. We will use float container and we will only use container. So copy the import of container and add them under testimonials.js. Copy the container element. You can remove this div tag and instead add a section. Add the ID testimonials and a class. Testimonials block. Then inside this section, you can paste the container element. For the title, let's use a div tag with a class title holder. For the title, I will use the S2 tag, client testimonials. Then for the subtitle, let's add another div tag with a class subtitle. You can copy the subtitle from the actual website and you can just paste it over here. Check the preview. You can see title and a subtitle. Now, let's add all of this content in carousel component. So go back to React Bootstrap, click components, carousel. Copy the import of carousel and add them on the very top. Then copy this carousel element and you can add them after the title holder div. Check the preview and we can see the carousel is working, which is good. Now, instead of this three carousel item, let's remove two of them. Also, remove this default content inside this carousel item. First, we want to show this description. So inside this carousel item, let's use a block code tag. Inside that tag, let's use p tag for the description. Then we need to add the name and the designation. So add a site tag. For the name, I will use span tag with a class name. So here I will show the name. Then I will use another span tag with a class designation. And here I will show the designation. This is the static content, but I want to show the dynamic one. So on top, I will paste the data, testimonials data. Here, we got properties like ID, name, description, and designation. To use this data, we can use a map function. So just after this carousel element, you can use testimonials data.map. We can then access testimonials. Inside return, let's add this carousel item. Now let's use the key attribute and add testimonials.id. To access the description, we can use testimonials.description. For the name, we can use testimonials.name. And finally, for the designation, we can use testimonials.designation. Check the preview, and we can see the testimonial is working fine. But if you look at the design, we don't have left and right arrow. To remove them, you can click on the API carousel. We can simply add controls and set them to false. So in the carousel element, add controls and set them to false. Check the preview again, and this time it is looking exactly the same as in design. Great. This is the end of this session. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get more videos in the future. Thank you.